presented live.
Here 1 hour only.
Tyrants.
Mm-hmm.
Merry Christmas, Mike.
Oh, Merry Christmas, Mike.
Joe?
Mike.
I'm so glad you people are here. I haven't had a chance to see many people lately.
Well, if it's any consolation, Mike, you're in our thoughts and frequently.
That's nice to know. I'll keep it in mind those times when I'm feeling lousy.
How are you coming, Mike? What does Dr. Lacey have to say?
Just what Mike doesn't want to hear. More of the same. Bed rest.
You're improving, though, Mike, aren't you?
Oh, yeah. But a hepatitis bug can be kind of stubborn. Takes time to get over it.
Yes, time and rest.
Yes, dear.
Well, if I know my son-in-law, you can keep his body in that bedroom, but his mind is going to be in that courtroom on Martha's trial.
Mm. How are they, Bill and Martha?
Well, they're doing as well as can be expected under the circumstances, Mother. I mean, to think of Martha being accused of willful murder.
Well, how does it look, Mike?
Well, Adam and I would be much happier if we could have gone into that courtroom with one solid piece of evidence.
Is there such evidence?
Oh, yes, Mother. The gun.
Oh, well, could that clear her?
Well, it certainly would tear holes in the prosecution's case. They're charging Martha with deliberate murder, saying that she picked up Taffy Simms' gun and fired it with intent to kill.
And that's absolute nonsense, really. I mean, anyone who knows Martha knows that what she says is true. The gun went off accidentally.
Now, for that to have happened, the gun must have had a hair trigger. Now, if we had it, if we could show that the slightest movement could have set that gun off, it certainly would help Martha's case.
Poor woman, she's been through so much.
Did you say they were coming by today, Nancy?
Oh, no, Dad. No, I did ask them if they wanted to, but they want to spend a quiet day at home. Laurie and Johnny are going to be by.
Oh.
And Adam and Brandy.
Adam and Brandy, they're coming together?
Why do you say that, Brandy?
Well, I mean, with Adam acting for the defense and Brandy for the prosecution, they're on opposite sides.
Well, it must be awkward for them, to say the least. And you think that if Brandy wins the case, it might affect the way she and Adam feel about each other, hmm?
Oh, Ted, it's bound to have an effect on their relationship.
That's true, Nancy. But if they really love each other, they'll manage to separate their private emotions from their professional responsibilities.
Yeah, maybe you're right.
Quite a tangle, isn't it? Sounds as though somebody's bound to be hurt. In every contest, there's always a winner and a loser.
Well, I just hope Martha isn't the loser.
This portion of The Edge of Night is brought to you by moist, delicious Duncan Hines Deluxe 2. They might not wait till it's frosted. And by Zest, the deodorant bar that leaves you feeling cleaner.
I'll never take a bath with my soap again, and I feel cleaner for it. I use deodorant Zest now. I'm a housewife. My name is Teresa Seeley. I used to use soap. When I saw with my own eyes that my soap left a sticky soap film and Zest didn't, even after rinsing, I sure wanted to try it, and I did. After bathing with Zest, I feel cleaner. I really like it. You don't want any sticky residue left on your skin, and Zest rinses off very well. Very well. I've changed to Zest, and I'm going to stay changed.
Soap? Give it up. Deodorant Zest makes you feel cleaner than soap.
Well, now that's delicious.
What's she going to say when Mom sees her cake?
Don't worry, son. I'll think of something.
My cake. It's not frosted.
Hon, it's great unfrosted. Taste.
Duncan Hines Deluxe 2. Our remarkably moist batter makes our cake so moist, even unfrosted, the taste comes alive.
It's delicious this way.
Mm-hmm. Duncan Hines Deluxe 2. So moist, so delicious, they might not wait till it's frosted.
You look terrific. Hey, John, come on, hurry up. Go ahead, go.
Listen, you son of a gun, you know that you are invited.
Invited?
No, really, Mrs. Carr, they said you get Mr. Maselli. That's you,
oh,
Danny Maselli.
Me.
Come over, have a little glass of Christmas cheer with us. Come on, why don't you come with us?
You're all set up here for tonight, Danny. Why don't you come?
Oh, I am set up. It's only,
Only what?
It's just going to be a little group of people that are getting together to cheer up Daddy.
Yeah, you see, Mr. Carr's been sick for a little while. I figure you and me go over there. We tell him a few Italian jokes, 30, you know.
Oh,
and
good. Stop. You ought to be ashamed. You know, your husband's been bananas. He's gone insane.
I know. I love him.
The truth of the matter is, I don't feel like socializing, and I would really like to be alone.
Listen, you okay?
Of course I'm okay.
I think it would do you good to get to be with some other people for a change, not just...
Come on, stop worrying about me, will you please go, huh? Stop worrying.
Listen, where's Tracy? She should be here.
Oh, you expect her to be on time, huh? Listen, why don't you just go, and when she comes here, I'll tell her to meet you over there, huh?
Maybe we should. What do you think, Laurie?
Well, it'd be kind of nice if we could arrive together.
Listen, would you take a little advice from me? Don't waste your good times on that girl. Just go, will you?
Hey, come on. It's the holidays, huh? She's trying.
Yeah, but she's trying what, John?
She is trying to do a good job, and she is trying to get along with you better.
Well, she can do that. That's all right. That's fine. That's good. No one's stopping her from doing that. Only don't expect me to run to the bank, take the money out, and put a bet on it.
Laurie, I think we're going to get no place with this guy. He's afflicted with a very common Italian disease called gabbadossa. Listen, you have a good holiday, huh?
Uh-huh. One another. Go ahead.
Yeah, sure. I'll get the car.
Oh. I sure wish you'd change your mind and come with us.
Will you go and stop worrying about me?
Danny, the only reason we worry about you is because we love you.
All right. Come on. Come on, Johnny is waiting, huh? Come on, Johnny. Oh, come on. Would I say something wrong?
No.
Then what is it?
I don't know. I guess it's the season.
Why?
I can't help worrying about you.
Don't worry about me. I'm all right.
Danny, you spend too much time alone.
I'm not alone. Miserable, yes, but not alone. One another.
Merry Christmas.
Fact. Martha Marceau shoots and kills Taffy Simms. She leaves the apartment. She goes home. She doesn't say a word one about it. Not even to her own husband, right? Fact. Taffy Simms' child is returned to the Marceaus. Compliments of the law, and still she says nothing. She's got the dead woman's child in her house, knowing she has killed that woman's mother, that kid's mother.
Isn't that pushing the point a bit too hard?
Knowing she has killed that child's mother, and still she says nothing. Silence, you see? Silence. Unwarranted, unexplainable. That's the point we've got to hit, and hit hard. Martha Marceau's silence equates with her guilt. Yeah, you're not even listening to a word I say. Come on, snap out of it. Look, this may not be the most difficult case my office has ever handled, but it's not a walk away either.
I didn't say it was a walk away.
Then stay with me, please.
I'm sorry. I just...
I know. It's the holiday season, but the crime rate does not go down just because it's the holidays. They go up, as a matter of fact.
Now, you have a wife, children, private life.
And that's it. It is private. I don't let it interfere with my work.
Your subtlety is not lost on me, and I am sorry that I brought it up.
I wasn't trying to be subtle. I was referring to your relationship with Adam Drake, counsel for the defense. Look, the conviction of Martha Marceau is highly important. This is a very big case. The news media are hungry for it. You'll be in the public eye for weeks.
I wonder why you find it necessary to remind me that I will be in the public eye when I am trying the case.
Why'd you decide to be a lawyer anyway? What do you look forward to? Your paycheck at the end of the week? I don't believe that.
You don't.
Oh. Now, what was it Oliver Wendell Holmes said about the rewards of labor, the prize?
Oh, wait. Something like, the only prize for the general would be not a bigger tent, but
to command, that is?
That's it.
And is that what you think I want, to command, to gain power?
Don't you?
I don't measure my life in terms of power, no.
I do. I intend to move on. And soon. Very soon. And this case is going to help me do it. Now, when I move on, the people in my office don't just sit there stamping their feet. They move too. And it could happen to you. You could be the first female district attorney this town has ever seen.
Little old me.
A little old you. You can have it. You can have it, Brandy, if you make a grab for it. Now, everybody in that courtroom's going to be watching you, watching how you perform.
I know they'll be watching me.
We have got to win this case.
And what if we don't win it? That is to say, what if I lose it for us? Does that mean I'll be suddenly joining the ranks of the unemployed? Is that what you're driving at, Ira?
Nobody buys a loser, baby.
Oh, well, there we have it, don't we? It's called win it or else.
Come on, Taffy, you will win this case if you keep your head screwed on straight. The people of this town are spending a big chunk of their tax dollar to bring Martha Marceau to trial. And that's what it is. It's a trial. It's not an exercise to test your loyalty or your faith or whatever it is your relationship is to Adam Drake.
You have no right to say that kind of thing.
I want us to get things straight. I want to win that case.
And I want to win it, too. And I have tried to assure you, Ira, that I will do everything I know how to win it. Excuse me.
Hi, Brandy. Hello, Adam.
Jimmy loves tagging along with Michael and trying the things that Mike has tried. You got a lot of dirt with children. You get a lot of clean with Tide.
Jimmy has to do everything as Big Brother Mike does. So they both wind up black with dirt. There's just nothing like the dirt kids get into. Look at Jimmy's pants. The dirt's ground clear through to his underpants. That's one of the reasons I count on Tide. See? With Tide, Jimmy's pants and underpants both came clean. And when the boys' clothes look this good, I know I can rely on Tide to get my whole wash clean.
Kids crossing streams are bound to get dirty just trying to reach the other side. You got a lot of dirt with children. You get a lot of clean with Tide. Tide was designed with mothers in mind. It gets at the dirt kids get into. You got a lot of dirt with children. You get a lot of clean with Tide.
Get Tide, because Tide gets out the dirt kids get into.
Am I interrupting an important meeting?
Oh, no. I'm glad you came.
Brandy, I called you earlier, but there was no answer.
I know. I wasn't here.
Miss Henderson and I have been rather busy today.
We're taking depositions.
Mm. Brandy, the Karrs have invited us over.
Oh.
He's feeling pretty bad.
Poor Mike. Hasn't been much of a holiday season for him, has
it? No, it hasn't, Ira. It's been a series of doctors and hospitals and back into the sick bed, and he feels particularly bad being laid up at this time.
I can understand that.
Well, you look absolutely marvelous. You don't even have to change.
Oh, we're going to go now?
Right now.
Excuse me, Adam, but I, sorry, but I have a lock on Miss Henderson's time today.
You have a what?
A lock. I'm sorry, we have work to do. Tell Mike she's sorry. We're busy.
I see.
I'm sorry.
It's all right. I understand. Bye.
Cooking dinner for your fiancé, eh?
Oh, Daddy, Harold's just a boyfriend.
Great-looking chicken.
Thank you.
It's very good. Real crisp.
Mom taught me. Crisco oil fries practically grease-free. I fried these four pieces in one cup of Crisco oil. And after allowing for this much chicken fat, all the oil came back except for one tablespoon.
Great chicken. It tastes terrific.
Harold, good cooks make good brides.
Brides?
Crisco oil fries practically grease-free.
Lunchtime?
Yep. Oh, no. Wash first. And use the lava.
That's not lava. Here's lava. It's got pumice. Extra help for the way kids wash. Beats all other bar soaps for getting hands clean the first time.
My towel. Who didn't use the lava?
Lava gets hands clean the first time.
We ask cats all over America what cat food they like best. The answer was unanimous. New Meow Mix from Purina. It's a tasty combination of three separate flavors, tuna, liver, and chicken. Each flavor a separate bite-sized morsel, so your cat gets three separate foods instead of one. Wise guy. New Meow Mix tastes so good, 9 out of 10 cats ask for it by name.
Bear has done it. Introducing new Bear Children's Cold Tablets. Relieves stuffy nose, reduces fever. Each tablet has an effective decongestant to unstuff stuffy noses, plus Bear aspirin to reduce fever. And it's in the dosage doctors recommend, all in chewable orange-flavored tablets. To unstuff a stuffy nose and reduce fever of a cold, get new Bear Children's Cold Tablets.
Well, there we are. Champagne for everyone.
Except the patient. He gets ginger ale.
Don't feel sorry for me. In this company, it tastes exactly like champagne.
Oh, isn't that lovely? Just for that, you get an extra 5 minutes.
Marvelous. Well, what'll we drink to? Is it too early to drink to the new year?
I don't think it is.
Johnny, do you have anything special you're wishing for?
Oh, I don't think I have to wish for everything. I've got everything.
Well, I have a wish. May all those people who are unhappy find happiness in the year to come.
Oh, here, here.
Here, here.
Oh, I've given up making wishes. At my age, I'm grateful for anything I can get.
That's not true, and you know it. She's always after me saying, Joe, I wish you do this, or Joe, I wish you do that.
Nancy, I know what you're wishing for.
Mother, don't worry about Martha. Her case is in good hands.
She's right, Nancy. If anybody can prove that Martha's innocent, Mike and Adam can.
Oh, please don't misunderstand. I don't doubt their abilities, their skills. It's just that they have so little to go on. Honey, are you all right? You feel warm. Please, do you have another finger? That's
fine.
All you need now. Huh?
Just stop worrying about me. I haven't felt this good in days. As a matter of fact, you promised me an hour and 5 minutes, and I intend to make the most of it.
It is I.
Hello.
Hi, Molly.
No.
Joe.
Oh, Merry Christmas,
hi, John.
Merry
get a glass.
Oh, good coming
right up. Merry Christmas, Adam.
John?
Merry Christmas.
Mr. Sorry. Drake?
Merry Christmas, Adam.
Merry Christmas, Adam.
Mike, Nancy.
Adam, Merry Christmas. Hey. Where's Brandy?
Oh, thank you, John. She's, working.
Oh, what? That's a shame.
Well, she has a conference with Paulson.
Paulson? Sometimes I wonder who winds that man up.
That's too bad, Adam. We were looking forward to spending some time with her.
So was I.
Our story continues after this message.
Just put it on the table, Chris.
That could have been a disaster. But this tabletop didn't break because it's acrylic. Transparent like glass, but a lot tougher. And this is the acrylic floor finish. Future. Acrylics make future transparent and keep it transparent, even in corners. And acrylics make future tougher than wax, for a shine that can really take it. Future. Beautifully transparent. Tougher than wax.
I always gave the furniture I built rubbed in paste wax beauty. But now I get paste wax beauty instantly. With new pledge. This table was rubbed with paste wax for 12 minutes and a lot of muscle. Now I'll dust this one with new pledge. You know, pledge now has an enriched formula containing key ingredients found in Johnson paste wax. To me, it's a dead ringer for the paste wax shine. So for the rubbed in beauty of paste wax instantly, dust with new pledge.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, it's beautiful. Hope you like it, Dad. It's a Christmas present for you. Well, I didn't give it to you before because... Well, I was afraid.
Afraid of what?
I didn't know how you'd take it, getting a gift from me. Well, you're always so...
Nasty?
That's not what I was going to say.
That's what you were thinking. Why don't you say what you were just thinking?
I was going to say unpredictable, that's all. Oh, come on, Danny. Here I am standing with a Christmas present for you, and you still won't let up on me.
Mm-hmm.
I went to a lot of trouble.
Well, I bet you did.
Well, I did. I had to decide what to get you. I had to go shopping.
You better be careful when you rip off merchandise from those big department stores. They got cameras all over the place. You can spot a crook like that.
I should have known better.
Hey, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Tracy, wait a minute. Wait a minute. I'm sorry. I really am sorry. I shouldn't have said a thing like that. It's not nice. What do you say you have a little Christmas drink with me, huh? What do you say? A little drink, huh? Huh? Good. Come on, sit down. Sit down. I'll get you a glass. Drink it straight?
Sure.
There you go. Bon another.
Chindan.
Ah, good.
Aren't you gonna open it?
Oh, yeah. Hey, I'm not too good at this, all right? That's nice. That's nice.
You really like it?
Yeah, that's nice. That's good.
I noticed you never wear a scarf, and it's getting awfully cold.
Yeah?
Is it the right color?
Well, it's perfect. It's perfect. It's, Yeah, I didn't get you nothing.
Oh, hey, that's okay. I wasn't expecting anything. Well, you've been so busy here with the restaurant and everything.
Yeah, well, holidays don't mean much to me.
Really?
Hmm.
They never meant anything to you?
Well, it's kind of... Things have changed.
What do you mean, changed?
Just changed, that's all. Changed.
You're talking about Babs, aren't you?
Well, we never had a Christmas together. Well, there was no time for that. There was no time. But the time we did have, let me tell you, was terrific. We used to have conversations about having kids, you know, and she wanted a boy and I wanted a girl, and I used to tell her, what do you want, another roughneck around the house? Boy, you got one already. And I said, but a girl, that's different. A girl is petite, you know, and she's has those tiny hands, and you pretend to bite the fingers so you can hear a giggle, you know, and or maybe you put her hand in yours and you walk down the street, and she's wearing a lot of petticoats and the skirt that's out to here like this, you know, and yeah, she wears a lot of petticoats. You know, I've missed a lot of things in my life. And half of them I really don't care about. But I sure do miss that little girl. And I miss my Babs.
steeped a string of pearls in a pot of tea, pearls made of denture material to prove extra strength effort and removes even stubborn stains between teeth in minutes. Watch as extra strength effort and powerful stain removers burst into action. In minutes, even the stubborn tea stains in between are cleaned. Get Effordent. And for extra strength in your denture adhesive, get Effergrip, stronger holding power from the makers of Effordent.
Campbell's in the cupboards like money in the bank.
That's the truth. Campbell's soup really helps me stretch a dollar. One night a week, we have a soup and sandwich supper. Sandwich fixings, milk and fruit, served with good hot Campbell's soup. Like chicken noodle. The family loves it. These days, I keep plenty of Campbell's soup in the cupboard.
When it comes to saving, it's the Campbell's you can thank. Campbell's in the cupboards like money in the bank.
Tune in again tomorrow for The Edge of Night. Was recorded. Stay tuned for The Price is Right, which follows on most of these CBS stations. Simms, inviting you to join us each weekday afternoon for The Edge of Night.